Hi, welcome back to my channel. My name is Rosie, and today we're going to be talking about aloe vera, which I have right here. If you don't have aloe vera, you can also find the gel. Obviously, it's always best fresh. And one of you guys left me a nice comment. This is by Suhani Sharma. Hey Rosie, I love your channel. I love your simplicity. Just yesterday I tried using the banana peel after seeing your video and the result on my skin was amazing. I have acne prone skin and even it's breaking out, but after using it, it really nourishes it. Can you do a video on aloe vera too? In this video, I'm gonna show you three ways that you can use aloe on your skin, on your hair, and how to drink. Since not only it has benefits to apply it on the outside, but also on your inside. So without talking anymore, let's begin. So one of the first ways that I like using aloe vera is for my face. As I mentioned before, you can use fresh aloe vera, which is better, but if you don't, you can always find from the store pre-made aloe vera gel, which I also have here. So for the mask, you will need aloe vera, just a small piece. You're going to add about 1 spoon of rose water. If you don't have it available, you can make it with roses. I already have a video on that, which you can check out. Or if you prefer, you can use lime juice. And then you can apply agave. So I'm just trying to use all plant-based ingredients. And you're just going to mix all the ingredients. Make sure to mash everything really well so you get rid of all the lumps. And once everything is blended really well, you're just going to apply it on your face like any other mask, just avoiding the eye area. So what this will do, the aloe vera has anti-inflammatory and antioxidants properties, so it's really good in your skin. If you have acne, it will reduce all the inflammation from the pimples. Or if you want to have fresh, soft skin, it's so good. I really like using this mask. Personally, I like using the rose water just because I love the scent. I love applying anything rose on me, and it's also a great way to nourish your skin. So for the next mask, it's going to be for your hair. So this is a great mask if you have dandruff or if you want shiny, healthy hair. And there's only 3 ingredients that you need. So the first one is coconut oil, which I love the scent of coconut oil. I just love anything coconut. And then you're just going to add a few drops of tea tree oil. This will give you like a fresh feeling, like a fresh sensation on your head. And then the aloe vera, just a small piece. Once you have all your ingredients, then all you have to do is blend everything really well. Make sure to mash everything so you don't have any lumps. And when you have it ready, just apply it on your head in small amounts and in every section of your head. I have been using this mask on Little Lynn when she has dandruff. The shampoos don't do much for her, but this is something that leaves her hair looking shiny. It looks hydrated and it removes the dandruff. I really love it. So the next one is a smoothie recipe. So you don't only get the benefits of aloe, not only on your outside, but also on the inside. You can use aloe for a juice, a lemonade, a smoothie. In this case, I'm going to share with you a smoothie recipe with simple ingredients. So the first ingredient, of course, the aloe, just a small piece. Then apple. You can use red apple or green apple. I used the green apple just because I wanted to keep everything green. And then lime juice, 1 lime. And then you can put water or OJ. And for extra benefits, I would have added spinach. I do have it, I just forgot. And then just put all the ingredients together in a cup and blend it away. And this smoothie, it's so good. It's so refreshing, especially on a hot day. It doesn't have to be hot. You can add some ice if you wanted to, but you can have the smoothie at any time of the year. But if it's hot outside, you can add some ice for extra refreshness. It's so good. It keeps you hydrated. I love it. So those are 3 ways that you can use aloe vera, not only on the outside, but on your skin, on your hair, so you don't only use it on the outside, but also on the inside. If there's anything that I forgot to mention in this video, it's going to be in the blog post, which I will link in the description box. And if you're interested, I have more recipes about beauty skin, beauty recipes, about how you can do your own makeup using kitchen ingredients. So I have 2 ebooks, one on vegan lifestyle and one more focused on beauty. So I will also have those links in the description box. You can follow me on all social media accounts with the same name, Lynn Sire. If you have liked this video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up and share it. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time. Kisses. Bye.